What would you do if you found out something you cherished was possessed? Would you try and throw it away? Destroy it? Maybe sell it to some unsuspecting buyer? And how did it become haunted in the first place? Those are the questions we're going to ask as we explore those very objects. Some you might be familiar with, others so obscure that they've been lost to the sands of time, until now. I'm your host, Evan O'Hare. Welcome to Haunted Objects.
Thanks for watching Haunted Objects. Make sure to subscribe to our channel, like this video, and click the bell so you can be notified when new episodes of Haunted Objects goes live. Now back to the show.
Weddings are a joyous occasion when family and friends come together to celebrate the unity with the one special person you're going to spend the rest of your life with. That is, unless you plan to do it in secret. Nestled in the small town of Altoona, Pennsylvania, is the Baker Mansion, originally home to the Iron Master Elias Baker and his family in the 1800s. Legend says Elias Baker was an overbearing man who ruled his family with an iron fist. When Elias's elder daughter, Anna, fell madly in love with a poor but handsome steelworker, Elias forbade her to go with this young man at all. Going against her father's demands, Anna and the young steelworker ended up planning their wedding in secret, even going as far as acquiring a wedding dress. Sadly, Elias found out about his daughter's plot and forced her fiancé to move away to a different city. Elias would offer other men he deemed qualified to be his daughter's husband, but Anna turned them all down. Instead, Anna locked herself in a room where she would dance around alone every night while wearing the dress she would never get married in. She'd eventually die an old maid in the very room, and after her death, the animosity and despair she had towards her father seemed to manifest in the dress. Members of the Baker family reported Anna's wedding dress would appear at different places around the house, with everyone denying to have moved it. Sightings of Anna roaming the hall still wearing the dress were also reported by the family. Today, the haunted dress remains on display in the Baker house. Visitors claim to have seen the dress shaking violently on its own and rocking back and forth as though it was dancing. Others say they've seen the apparition of a young woman dancing around in the mansion. Is it possible for an article of clothing to become animated by an angry, bitter spirit? Well, if you're ever traveling through Pennsylvania, be sure to stop by over at the Altoona Baker Mansion. Discover for yourself if this object of true love is indeed possessed. Whether the cursed objects shown this evening are of myth, urban legend, or fantastical paranormal occurrences is for you to decide. I hope I haven't left you eyeballing your shelves and contemplating your latest thrift shop purchase. But if I did, get in touch. Tell us about your possessed possession. And maybe we'll feature it right here on Haunted Objects.
Thank you for listening to Haunted Objects, brought to you by Resurrection Films, hosted by Evan O'Hare, and produced by Shawnee Elise Cook, directed and edited by Jason D. Morris. Written by Carly Street, Mark Francisco, and Jason D. Morris. Co-produced by Troy L. Foreman and Jason Hewlett. Executive produced by Resurrection Films and Berg Garabedian. Haunted Objects was originally aired on the Paranormal Network for Joe Blow Media, Inc.